Time now, 16 minutes before the hour.
Well, in the business world, if you've watched our business reports over the last several months, you've already become acquainted with a man who is really a buccaneer on Wall Street. T. Boone Pickens is his name. Mesa Petroleum is the name of the company from Amarillo, Texas. It's 92nd, by the way, in the oil industry, but it is out no less than to take over the Goliath of Gulf itself. We thought it was about time that we met Boone Pickens ourselves, and so we asked him to come in this morning and join us. And we're so delighted that you did, really are.
Thank you. I'm delighted to be here.
And we are not going to say T. Boone Pickens anymore. I'm told that Boone is the informal and correct approach.
Thank you.
So you've corrected us, and we stand so corrected. Let me ask you this. When you're sitting in your hotel room, and again, we have turned you into a mythical giant sitting in your hotel room, deciding which oil company you're going to go after, how do you make a calculation? Which one? Other investors have to invest in much smaller fashion in stocks all the time.
Well, Diane, this is, of course, a part of our business, and it has been for many years. And so we have a very good book on the industry, so it's not hard to pick out the companies that we're most interested in.
But how did you choose Gulf?
Well, Gulf has a large percentage of their reserves are domestic reserves, which is important to us. The company's image has not been good over the past number of years. The company was selling on the lower end of the cash flow multiples for the integrated oil companies, 2.5 times cash flow.
Yeah.
And it was selling at only a fraction of appraised value.
Now, it is no secret that you have, through losing at, with Citi Service, you lost in Gulf, who knows what will happen there, but that you've made about $500 million through losing on your attempted takeovers. Do you go into it anticipating that a loss is still going to stand you very well?
Well, you never like to lose, and it's interesting how large that figure gets, but you're a little high at $500 million.
Oh, I am?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
you never want to lose at whatever you set out to do, and we had sincere efforts to take over the Citi Service Company and also General American. It just so happened we got topped out. And so we don't like to lose, but if you lose and make money, well, it makes it a little easier.
All right. Now, since he is our touchstone for most of us, for oil company executives, tell me what you really think of J.R. Ewing as a prototype.
You know, I've never watched that show completely through. I've watched, you know, just a piece of it. I haven't really watched Dallas that.
So you don't know.
I would say that J.R. Ewing is certainly not a typical oil person.
Why is that?
Well, I think he has a lot of the problems we don't have. We have more marketing problems. He has problems with people. And so.
But you are considered anything from a maverick to a pest. I read in Wall Street this morning and the Wall Street Journal this morning. Does that trouble you?
Oh no, no. I think we've made a good analysis in the deals we've been in. I think we know what we're doing. I think we work very hard for stockholders, I think it's perceived that way.
But why, except for you and your sense of mischief, why aren't other companies out doing what you're doing all of the time? I mean, you really are kind of a maverick down there, aren't you?
Well, there are not many others that are doing this. I'll agree with you on that.
And why you?
Well, again, I think we work very hard for stockholders. In this case, we happen to be working for Gulf stockholders along with Mesa stockholders. And I've been identified as a stockholder advocate, and I think I am.
But it takes an extra sense of daring, doesn't it? Do you get nervous in the middle of these? Do you worry that maybe one or the other, you've made a big mistake?
No, I don't. I don't worry. That'll give you a stomachache if you start worrying.
What do you do for fun?
Oh, I have a lot of things. Our family will be with us at Thanksgiving, and we'll be hunting at our ranch northeast of Amarillo, about 90 miles. And I'm a racquetball player. I play some tennis. I love to play cards. You know, there are a lot of things that I do. I probably have too many hobbies.
Right. When you're not sitting in the hotel room taking over big businesses. Well, again, Boone Pickens, as we now say informally, it's great to meet you. And
thank
awfully
you.
Good of you to come by. And for those of us, again, you have become a standard part of our business report.
Well, thank you very much.
So we were glad to give a face to the name. Good to see you. And we'll be back in a moment with the War of the Chickens